Hello YouTubers and welcome to another video. In this video, I'm going to show you a tips on how to safely remove an Ibanez knob and not any kind of Ibanez knob, a very special Ibanez guitar knobs, which is this type. I hope you have seen this before, this kind of knob, and there is another video in YouTube where another guy is showing how the same process is done. So I'm not competing with anybody, I'm just trying to complement the knowledge so that more people will discover either my video or his video or some other guy video which shows the same thing, and you might choose which video is considered easier for you to understand. So even though my English is not good, so this particular knob is not your average knobs. Unlike the knob that you see on your guitars, there are two types, which is the screw on the side type and also the push-in type. This is a special type where it uses a collet securing type technology, if I may say so. So what you do is, at first, what you don't do with this knob, if you want to remove the knobs, is try to jack it up. You might break the mechanical thing in the knob itself, and also breaking the pots at the same time. So there's several parts to the knob that you need to understand. The top part is actually a threaded cap. So this cap is threaded. So you may find your knobs to be very tight, it doesn't move. The same also found on this guitar. If you like press the knobs body and slowly counterclockwise turning it, and it will slowly and surely thread out easily. And when that's done, you may want to clean the edges where the surface caps touch this thing, in order for you to easily take it out in future. Now, as soon as that comes off, you will see what you think, or what I thought was is a slotted place for you to put a slot screwdriver, which is not. That is part of the pots itself, and you need an Allen key. I didn't see this at first, because I saw something like a hexagon shape, but I just guessed, and my guess was and I was right. So you put a 3mm Allen key, and preferably hold the knobs and counterclockwise. This itself is what I may call the chuck that's holding the collet, which you will see in a minute. So the chuck is out, and out comes the take note of this brass washer, don't lose it. And that is the collet thing that securing the knobs to the pots. So this, there's a brass ring there, and this is the what I mean by the collets type. You see this in router bits, chuck, and similar concept is found in CNC spindle motor chuck, and those kind of thing, where it's very it's proven to be good in securing or holding an end mill or something. So after you done that, you can remove the pots if you want to change it or replace it to another brand. I think this would work also with CTS pots, because the slit here will fit, I think, CTS pots, and it doesn't matter whether it's slightly bigger than this, because it will adapt to the diameter of the pots. in general for guitars. So upon putting it back, you put this first, and then you put the ring. This is you have to put it in the right way. What I mean by the right way is, if you put it the wrong way, it won't fit. Okay, like that. No matter how you push it, it won't fit. So you have to put it the right way. And notice there is a detent there. That is what I think. That is a something like a keyway. That should be for the something like a keyway on the knob itself to match. So you should put it on the exact spot. If you do not, it will be like this, and you won't be able to secure the chuck type screw. So you need to find the keyway to match it with the key slot in the knob itself. So this is already in correctly, and you redo what you did earlier by holding the knob and tightening the Allen screw, and put on the caps clockwise, and you're done. So thank you for watching, and sorry that this took 6 minutes of your precious time. Thank you for watching, and bye bye.